is myself, Oberia Shilpa. Hope you liked the first video. And today I'm going to continue with the second video. Class 3, Subject Science, Chapter Name, Food and Feeding Habits of Animals, Part 2. First, let's recapitulate from Part 1 video of Food and Feeding Habits of Animals. In that, we have learned about 4 points. First, why do animals need food? We have learned that animals need food to get energy, to grow from baby to adult, and for a good health. Second is 3 types of animals according to their feeding habits, that is herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. Plant-eating animals are called herbivorous animals, flesh-eating animals are called carnivorous animals, and the animals that eat both plants and the flesh of other animals are called omnivorous animals. Third point is pets and domestic animals. The animals that we keep at our homes as friends are called pets, and the animals that we keep because they are useful to us are called domestic animals. Last and the fourth is food chain. A chain of living things in which one is eaten by the next is called food chain. Now today we are going to learn about how animals eat their food. The feeding habits of an animal depend on the types of food it eats. The mouth of an animal is suited to the type of food it eats. Here first is chewing the cud. Some grass-eating animals like cows, buffaloes, sheep first swallow their food to fill their stomach. Later, they bring the food back from their stomach into the mouth and keep chewing it for a long time with their grinding teeth. And this is called chewing the cud. Animals that chew the cud are cow, goat, buffalo, camel, sheep, bullock, etc. Second is gnawing. Gnaw means to bite something repeatedly or chew it hard. Animals like rabbits and rats have sharp front teeth that help them to gnaw on hard food like nuts, fruits, and seeds. Rabbits, squirrels, rats, and porcupines are such gnawing animals. Third is swallowing. Some flesh-eating animals like snake swallow their whole food. As you see, they do not bite or chew their food, so they do not have biting or chewing teeth. Frog also swallows its whole food. A frog has a long and sticky tongue that you can see in the picture. When a frog spots an insect, it takes aim and throws its tongue very quickly at it. Once the insect gets stuck on the tongue, the frog pulls its tongue back into the mouth and swallows it. It's amazing to know that an earthworm swallows soil, which has parts of dead plants and animals in it. They get nutrition from these decayed plants and animals. Now next is sucking. Insects like mosquitoes and butterflies have special mouth parts. It has a tube-like structure called proboscis to suck their food. In this, you can see how butterflies suck nectar from flowers and mosquitoes suck blood from human bodies. Another is lapping. Dogs and cats use their tongue to drink water or milk, as you see on the screen. There are some animals that eat the flesh of other animals, so they have very sharp, pointed, and curved front teeth to tear flesh. They also have strong grinding teeth at the back of their mouth to chew the meat and bones. These are the examples of animals that tear and chew the flesh. They are fox, tiger, lion and dog. Now let's see some feeding habits of other animals. We all have seen elephant, right? They have a long, thick trunk. Elephant uses its trunk to do various things. It uses its trunk to uproot grass, to break off branches and leaves of trees, and also to push the food into the mouth. They also use the trunk to drink water. Children, have you seen they use their trunk to have shower also? Now next is giraffe. Giraffe is known for its long neck, which help them to reach and break off leaves from tall trees. Children, we know that birds have no teeth. That's why they swallow their food. But usually, birds swallow some stone along with their food. These stones help them in crushing the grains they eat. So we have seen many animals' feeding habits. Now our next topic is taking care of animals. We should be kind to animals and not to harm them or hit them. All animals need protection and care. See children, we like when somebody cares for us. In the same way, animals also need care and attention to keep them healthy, happy and safe. Likewise, we should protect and care for wild animals also by protecting their natural environment and respecting them when we invade their environment. Second is providing good food and clean drinking water to our pets and domestic animals. We should be careful when choosing the types of food for the animals, as food is a great way to keep them healthy and happy. Always remember, food and water given to these animals have to be of good quality and good quantity. Third, as animals do not clean their shed, so it's our duty to clean their shed regularly. Cleanliness helps them to stay healthy and hygiene. Next is, sick animals must be treated in time. They deserve veterinary care so as to ensure that the animals have good health. If our pets or domestic animals fall sick, we have to take them to vet and have to take proper care of them. Another is, animals should be groomed or bathed regularly. We should trim their nails as it prevents problems with their walking. And bathing them can reduce denture and itching and will make our animals more comfortable. Last but not the least is, we should be kind and helpful to our pets and other animals. Our pets bring us joy, make us laugh, and give us unconditional love. So we should never tease or beat the animals. We should treat them as living things, not as an animal. So today we have learned about the ways an animal eat their food and few tips about how to take care of animals. Now it's time for an oral questioning. In this, you have to say any two animals that swallow their food and know their food. And in the second, you have to match the animals with the favorite food that they like to eat the most. As you see in the table, the animals are given like rabbit, lion, elephant, cow and frog. And in opposite of that, their favorite food is given. You have to match it correctly. So that's it. Here is the end of our lesson. That is food and feeding habits of animal. Thank you. Bye.